Hi. We are in December 20th, 2007. Only a few days ahead will be Christmas, and I'm going to speak about Christmas because it has nothing to do with Jesus. Why? If you are a Bible-believing Christian like I am, I'm a Catholic, Bible-believing Christian, which means I believe in whatever the Bible says, then you will take as an authority the Bible. In the Bible there is no evidence that Jesus was born in the 24th, and so it's not his birthday. But I'm going to follow the majority of people, what they think, and I'm going to take as a criteria the Catholic Online Encyclopedia. Let's leave the Bible aside, because probably you are not a Bible-believing Christian. You believe that the Bible contains the Word of God. It is an emanation of the Word of God, but it's not 100% authority. And the authority is what people say, what the majority of people think, and what the majority of people do. So if you are of that type of person, which I respect, of course, then probably you will give more more weight to an encyclopedia or to mass media, encyclopedia, these things, or philosophy or logic. These are the things that count more than the Bible. So for a non-believing Christian, of course. So if we go back to the Catholic Online Encyclopedia, I'm a Catholic, I'm a Bible-believing Catholic, as I said before. I can quote a few things about Christmas, what the Catholic Online Encyclopedia, and not only online, but the Catholic Encyclopedia of a paper, you can also see it. But if you don't believe me, you can go to a website, to a search engine, and you can find everything what I'm quoting. Quote from the Catholic Encyclopedia. Christmas was not among the earliest festivals of the Church. Irenaeus and Tertullian, so we're going back to the early fathers of the Christian Church, let aside the Apostle Paul, who wrote two-thirds of the New Testament, let aside Peter, who did not celebrate Christmas, let aside Jesus, who did not give any orders to celebrate his birthday, let aside all the apostles who did not celebrate any birthday whatsoever, and we have the Bible is made of hundreds and hundreds of pages. We see only two persons celebrated their birthday, and they were two evil persons. In the Old Testament, the Pharaoh, and in the New Testament, it was Herod. I did not say this following any strange sect or kooky people. I followed it by reading the Word of God. Only two groups of people celebrate their birthday. So Jesus, Peter, Paul, all the apostles, they never celebrated their birthday or other people's birthday. But let aside the Bible and let's see what the early fathers of the Church, you know, a few hundred years after Christ, what they thought about it. And here we see that the Irenaeus and Tertullian, quote, omitted from the lists of feasts. Origen, another Church of the Father, glancing perhaps at the discreditable imperial Natalitia, asserts that in the Scriptures sinners alone, not saints, celebrate their birthday. Arnobius ridiculed the birthdays of the gods. Unquote. Quote again from the Catholic Encyclopedia, the first evidence of the feast is in Egypt. Yes, first evidence of Christmas was in Egypt, 200 after Christ, AD. We see that Clement of Alexandria says that certain Egyptian theologians over-curiously assign not the year alone, but the day of Christ's birth, placing it on 20th of May, in the 28th year of Augustus. This checks the so-called correspondence between Cyril of Jerusalem and Pope Julius I to convert Armenia to December 25. Cyril declares that his clergy cannot, on the single feast of the birth and baptism, make a double procession to Bethlehem and Jordan, So he asked Julius to assign the true date of nativity from census documents brought by Titus to Rome. So Julius assigned it to which date? Try to guess. Yes, December 21st. Unquote. This is from the Encyclopedia. So we note here that in Rome, the historical civil calendar had on the 21st of December always marked as Die Natalis Sol Invictus. And I went to a big public library in Rome, in Castro Pretorio, many years ago, before the advent of the internet, and I looked at myself. I wanted to see what the 25th of December was marked as before the advent of Christ, before the arrival of Christ, and it was marked as Die Natalis Sol Invictus, which meant the day of the birth of the invincible sun, the birthday of the sun, a sun god. And that was a totally pagan holiday to worship the sun. It was also abbreviated as a Natalis Invicti, Natalis Invicti. So it was a very old pagan holiday, many, many centuries before the arrival of Jesus Christ. I will quote again the Online Catholic Encyclopedia, quote, concerning the date of Christ's birth in the Bible and the New Testament gives no help. But logic can help us think that the census, there is a census means mentioned in that period in the New Testament,